A very warm welcome to NTV Sport. Now, it's all empty here, but tomorrow, Mandela National Stadium will be a sea of people as Uganda plays its fourth fixture in the 2017 Africa Cup of Nations qualifying campaign. It's amazing just what one match day, or two in the case of Botswana, can do. Now, after losing its first match of the campaign on Saturday, Uganda finds itself with the same number of points as Burkina Faso and Botswana, that is six. Now, Uganda will, of course, play Burkina Faso here under the lights tomorrow. Robert Madoy, as usual, is here to talk a little more about that match. And Robert, the Cranes will be sporting black armbands, and we know why.
Yes, Joel, it's a pretty sad day for Ugandan football following the passing of Abel Dhaira. He was just 28 years, which is young by any measure. He passed, obviously, after battling with abdominal cancer. It's a very sad story, very poignant story. If you remember, in 2008, Abel Dhaira won the SEKAFA Senior Challenge Cup here in Uganda, which was played here at this stadium. He was a goalkeeper whom you could say put the F back into goalkeeping, and by F I mean fan. He was a stylish goalkeeper, the sort of keeper whom you can call a playing goalkeeper, loved, you know, to play with the ball, you know, to juggle it around and do these kinds of things that would obviously interest the fans. Very sad that he passed on, Joel, yesterday. The news broke yesterday, and this is how they received it at his home in Walukuba Jinja.
Basebo nebanyabo tufunya mawulira agecheka okusawa 10 kitundu ezawano nga muganda wafe muzanyi w'omupiira amanyikiddwa Abel Dhaira ng'awumudde ng'obulwadde bwa kansa bwemujje mu bulamu bw'ensi eno. Ekisinze twewuunyisa nti eri mu Iceland ate bo balimwagala nnyo, balimwagala baagala bamuziika eyo nga batugamba nti option esooka gye basobosa tuwa ntajja kuziikibwa eyo ku kyaki gy'abadde asabirako era nga tera n'okubuulira ku sandi. Option ey'okubiri nti waakwokyebwa ajja kwokye baffe basobola tuweereza evvu. Then option ey'okusatu tukwate mu nsawo tutambuze omulambo kuba ndoza kilabu tali wiringi okutambuza enjoli yabo okugiza wano.
Now, of course, very sad indeed about Abel Dhaira there. That was yesterday, of course. There have been new developments today. I can tell you that the government of Uganda has come to the rescue of the Dhaira family. Linda Nabusai Wamboka, the press secretary to the president, confirmed in a tweet that government will foot the expenses for the return of the remains of the fallen Cranes goalkeeper.
Yes, Joel, they've chipped in with $15,000 that was needed, as we had earlier in that bite there. Abel Dhaira, the goalkeeper, I keep mixing him up with Bright, his father. But Abel Dhaira there, he faced, you know, that prospect of having his body cremated and his ashes sent back here to Uganda if they didn't come up with $15,000, and government obviously has sprung to the rescue of the family.
All right, now, staying with Dhaira, we talked to his father, Bright, who Robert has just been talking about, who also kept goal for the Cranes. We have more in this report.
I advise the world to be aware of the cancer disease. And I urge each and everybody to go for medical checkup. But I still thank the world because they have loved Dhaira. They love Dhaira. Though he's dead, they have shown me that they still love him.
All right, back to the football. I would imagine Cranes players will want to honor Abel Dhaira's memory by winning tomorrow's match. Let's just take a look at how some of the Cranes players have been remembering Dhaira.
I'm so tired of being here, suppressed by all my childish fears. And if you have to leave, I wish that you would just leave, 'cause your presence still lingers here, and it won't leave me alone. These wounds won't seem to heal, this pain is just too real. There's just too much that time cannot. Cried, I'd wipe
past and current Cranes players remembering Abel Dhaira there. Let's move on, because lest we forget, there's a match that will be played here tomorrow. It's a given that it will be a somber mood. Robert, how does the jet lag affect the team? Because we know they got here early this morning while Burkina Faso got here yesterday.
Yeah, very big issue, Joel. 19-hour flight. I was just talking to the Cranes coach, that's Milton Michos-Ridojevic, and he was telling me of the recovery process of the players. Obviously, they had to do a few warm-up drills during the stopover they had at Addis Ababa, which was really unsightly. But the big question for him is he going to rejig, that side? Many people seem to think that he will. Joel, if we may take a look at the team that played against Burkina Faso in Ouagadougou, it's a pretty familiar team, the back line there, we can see Denis Onyango in goal. In front of him, you have the central defensive pairing of Isaac Isinde, and you also have Murushid Juko, the Tanzanian best defender, and flanking him on the wings, the fullbacks, you have Dennis Guma, and also you have Joseph Ochaya. The back line really acquitted itself, if I may say. They played really well, but they had their backs to the wall. I don't think he's going to change it, but the holding midfielders there, you have Khalid Awucho, who gave away that penalty. He did not really do himself a world of good by doing that, but I thought he was also decent. Tony Maweje, many people are skeptical. He's not playing, skeptical about whether he was rusty or not. People seem to think that he was going to be out of his depth, considering that he hasn't been playing football. The league in Iceland is off; it's on the back burner. But I thought he also chipped in with a very solid display. In fact, he was one of my better outfield players.
Now, of course, Uganda's opponents tomorrow arrived from Ouagadougou yesterday, as we've just told you. Derek Ntege has been watching how they are preparing for tomorrow's match in our report.
Burkina Faso Stallions looked fresh as they had light drills at Mandela National Stadium this evening. The team included acclaimed names like Bertrand Traoré of Chelsea, Saturday's match winner Jonathan Pitriopa, and Arised Bansei. The last time Burkina Faso played in Uganda was 2005. The 2006 World Cup qualifier was played under the lights. Uganda needed a late equalizer by Geoffrey Serunkuma to share the spoils in a thrilling 2-2 draw. Tomorrow's match will also be played under the lights at Mandela National Stadium. Paolo Duarte is confident going one better this time round.
1 point is not bad, but we don't want 1 point. We want the 3 points. But after the game, we can see if I win 1 point, 3 points. Or...
Duarte says he dreads one player.
Massa, is not young, but he's very strong.
Geoffrey Massa has scored all his 26 Crane goals at Mandela National Stadium.
That is it from us here at the Mandela National Stadium. Remember, tomorrow's match will kick off at 7 p.m. local time. A win will take Uganda back at the summit of Group D. Do join us tomorrow as we break down what will have happened in that match.